Thank you. Thank you. block by Schaefer, but just out.
Yeah.
Schaefer dumps it, and there's a kill from Harper Schaefer. Smart play, recognizing a tight pass. Maybe the front row, she has an option for that dump. Smart goes over the two hands. Finds it 4-4 the judges. goes to the middle, tipped over, out of the reach of an outstretched Harper Schaefer. That's a kill from Kevin. A smart play by the middle there, recognizing the block from the Miles in the front row. Tipping it just around and applied. Difficult for the left and right side.
Dump over from Danae Bristow, puts the point away.
Crystal at that point with a big block on the slide on Kevin Ellis. And with that second touch, right down to position number three. Now a substitution for the Nook. It'll be Karin Bojcik. Same play as last time. Even that box a little over the net, makes no mistake with a two-hand dump over the net. It's great discipline there by Bristow. So many players would want to just absolutely pound that ball with one hand and risk either missing or getting the net. Smart shot there by Bristow. Just put the ball away. Serve goes just long for Cameron Higgins. And now the man will check back in for her. It was a good run by Higgins. But a huge block by the GGs. Wang Yao tried to kick it back over, but a shot. Point. Great job by the rookie there. Elevating, getting that right hand up in the crest. Shutting down the swing from the left side. And another GGs rookie check in. And an ace for Kevin Mount. Confusion between DG and Jones. And an ace. He's running that first pass up. It'll be Bristow checking back in for the game. DG thought the substitution was for her, but no, Bristow has to check back in for the person. There's a kill from Audrey Odigi. Touches off off the block and is going to be okay. Looks like she is. Scary play there. Fell for the first play. All busy, all the play. Collective side for me. For one, see her get up just fine.
All right, fans, please welcome.
Welcome back inside Malpitsy Hall for the third set of the women's volleyball match between your UOttawa GGs and the Université de Québec as Chicoutimi Inuk. The GGs have taken the first two sets by scores of 25-10 and 25-21 respectively, looking to close things out here in the third set at home on a beautiful Friday night in Ottawa. Third set about to get underway. It'll be number three, Christelle Bergeron, on serve for the Inuk. Schaefer to the left side for ODG, tipped over, and we'll start off the third set the way a lot of GG's points end, with a kill from Audrey ODG. This time a smart little tip down the line gives the GG's the lead early on, and it'll be Danica Robile to serve. Janae McKay now back in the game for the third set, replacing Alana Leung. And Robar serves a good one. Le Tourneau goes to the middle. Swing there was number 11, Lena Caranaut, and she gets the kill. Waterfall off the hands of Janae McKay. Got the block touch, but fell on her own side. Point to the Inuk. Caranaut now on serve for the Inuk. Her float taken by Giddens. Schaefer goes to the outside. ODG put it over, now gets it back. Schaefer goes to McKay this time. Swing goes long, point to the Inuk. No block touch, says the down official. Lionel Woods may disagree, but point goes to the Inuk either way. Now another serve here from Caranaut. Flat float, well taken by Lewis. Schaefer goes to the middle for McKay, and this time she gets the kill off the hands of Caranaut in the back row and out. Great swing by McKay, good set by Schaefer to set her up. And she'll now step back to serve. Gigi's with three of their best hitting options in the front row right now, ODG, McKay, and Hildebrand. Great touch by Lewis. Great touch by ODG. And McKay finally somehow gets that ball over. Now Le Tourneau goes to the middle, blocked by ODG. Left side swing from Roussel, popped up by Giddens. Schaefer to the middle for McKay. Great dig by Gagnon. Roussel sets and a swing out of the back row. Long run Lewis, she gets it up. Schaefer puts it over, and this point's still going. Le Tourneau to the left side for Roussel, and a block by Nicole Hildebrand ends the point for the GGs. A monster rally ended with a stuffed block by Hildebrand. Her 37th on the season, 19th solo block. And all of the entire gym can breathe a collective sigh of relief there. What a rally. Great saves by both teams. Finished off by Hildebrand. And the GGs win another point here. Le Tourneau went to the slide for Corinne Bernier, but her shot unable to get over the tape. The GGs now lead by a score of 4-2. Substitution for the Inuk is number 14 coming in, Lauriane Roussel, the middle in favor of Corinne Bernier. Lauriane Roussel started this game, didn't play in the second set, and now is back in the third. Serve from Schaefer is a good one. Gagnon, long run. Roll shot over, goes deep. Giddens leaves it, tracks it well, and it goes long for a point for the GGs. The swing from Bergeron out of the back row wasn't necessarily a bad one. Tough to swing on those back row balls, especially when the set's already coming from the back row, but good job by Giddens tracking that all the way to the back line, letting it fall just out. Schaefer with another serve. Le Tourneau go to Roussel. And a kill from Elodie Roussel. Good shot by the left side there, turning her body, going down the line, beating the block of McKay and Hildebrand. Difficult thing to do as the two lead the team in blocks, but Roussel makes a good shot, and the Inuk are within two. Le Tourneau's serve, popped up Lewis, long run Schaefer, puts it out to Hildebrand, she'll put it over. Bit of confusion by the Inuk there, and a point to the GGs off a free ball. In that case, it's probably the right side's ball as Le Tourneau coming out of the back row wants to get to the front so she can set that ball. The right side's got to recognize on the free ball. She's got to peel off the net, take anything short in that case, Détourneau No had to dive and take that first ball, and the rest was history. The Inuk get one right back, though, as Lauriane Roussel with a big swing out of the middle. Gigi's unable to get that dig up. And the Gigi's lead cut to 2 points. They lead now by a score of 6-4.
Elodie Roussel with the serve.
Now here's a serve from Elodie Roussel. Her standing float. Taken with the hands of Odigi. Schaefer reverses the flow, goes to Hildebrand in the back row, makes no mistake. Great swing into the deep corner, position number one, out of the reach of an outstretched Elodie Roussel, unable to pick it up, and a point to the Gigi's. Now Janae McKay on serve. Her jump float goes just wide. That'll be a point to the Inuk. Right idea from McKay, trying to pick a corner. Unfortunately, just drifted on her a little bit. And the serve will belong to Lauriane Roussel of Chicoutimi. Her float, high pass from Lewis, but off target. Giddens takes it. Odigi rolls one in, tight pass. And Robert finishes it off. Nice play by the middle there. Well coached this team is to stay disciplined and throw those balls down with two hands. Robert's done it a few times, as did Bristow in the second set. And Gigi's have been hitting almost 100% on those balls. Now a serve from Hildebrand. Passes off, long run, Létourneau. Bergeron rolls it over. Good dig by Jones. Schaefer goes to the C ball for Hildebrand, rolled over. And a kill from Nicole Hildebrand. Bit of a miscommunication between Roussel and Gagnon in the back row. Led to that libero taking it out of the hands of the left side pretty much. But unfortunately, with Gagnon having to go for a long run, couldn't quite get that pass on target. Skipped off her hands out the back, and a kill from Hildebrand. Can't follow it up though. Missed serve by Hildebrand, gives the point and the serve to the Inuk. And it'll be Corinne Hood to serve for Chicoutimi. Hood's serve. Great pass by Lewis. Schaefer, Giddens, blocked and no coverage in the back row. Point to the Inuk. Tough coverage there by the Gigi's. It's almost impossible on those left side balls, especially when you have your back row left side trying to run a pipe. When those balls go deep, it's almost impossible to dig them up. Great hustle by Schaefer. Giddens puts it barely over. Létourneau gives it to the middle for Caranaut, but a dig from Odigi. Now Hildebrand hits the C ball. Létourneau to the left side for Bergeron. Another dig from Odigi. Schaefer dumps. Gagnon managed to pop it up. Swing from Bergeron into the net, and a point for the Gigi's. Good defense in the back row by the Gigi's. Leads to some offense and a point. And the serve belonging to Cameron Giddens. Odigi, Schaefer, and Rabair in the front row for the Gigi's. Jones, Hildebrand, and Giddens in the back. And a swing went in, off the tape, bounced in. Giddens got caught looking on that one. And the Gigi's will give up serve as the Inuk take it back. It'll be Christelle Bergeron to serve. From the vantage point in the commentator booth here, it looked like that ball went wide, but Lions person's got a great angle on it. Landed just in. Now Odigi with a swing. Block touch and a point to the Gigi's. Smart shot by Odigi. Just finding those hands off of Létourneau's pinky, it looks like. She rubs that finger on the court. And the Gigi's will serve. It'll be Danica Robert. Robert's float. High pass. Gagnon sets out of system. Bergeron gives a free ball over. Hildebrand takes. Schaefer dumps. Gagnon picks it up. Létourneau the set. Goes to Roussel on the left side. Blocked by McKay and Schaefer. Now a slide. No one's there for it. And the Gigi's win the point. Bit of confusion there between Hood and Caranaut. Looks like they weren't sure whether that was supposed to be a C ball for Hood to swing on or a slide for Caranaut. And in the end, no one went for it. They ended up looking at each other as that ball hit the ground. And Danica Rabaya will serve again. Good serve. Roll shot from the libero. Schaefer just got it over, did McKay. Schaefer goes to the left side. Odigi puts it over, and it lands just in. Karin Udd thought it was going to fall out. Dove for it, but pulled up at the last minute. And Odigi just chuckled and watched as that ball fell right on the line. Now a substitution for the Inuk. It'll be Victoria Di Pietrantonio coming in for Karin Udd. Rabail with serve. Long run, Le Tourneau, and an ace for Danica Rabail. Puts the serve right on number 9, Di Pietrantonio, who just checked in. Always tough coming in cold and having to get that first ball served right at you. And she got aced by Rabail on that one. Now another serve from her, this time at Gagnon. Another long run from Le Tourneau. Roussel puts it over. Odigi pops it up. Schaefer sets the pipe for Giddens. Le Tourneau goes to the left for Roussel, tipped over. Odigi once there. Another pipe swing for Giddens. Dig by Di Pietrantonio. Roussel with the swing over, this time dug by Giddens. Schaefer goes to the left side for Odigi, rolled over, dug by Roussel. Le Tourneau to Di Pietrantonio. Hildebrand with a good pop-up. Schaefer to the middle to McKay, and there's a kill. Tried the pipe twice, couldn't get it. Tried the left side once, couldn't get it. And on the fourth run, Janae McKay gets the kill out of the middle. Good job of Schaefer running all her options there. And the GGs open up a 15-8 lead. Shikutsumi calls their first timeout. Gigi's leading this third set by a score of 15-8. It's Danica Rabail still on serve for UOttawa as they look to close out this match in three sets against the University of Quebec at Chicoutimi. Gigi's won the first two. But the Inuk get one back right off the serve. Le Tourneau goes to Lena Karanaut in the middle on the slide play. And Chicoutimi will take the serve back. Karanaut, following her kill, will step back to serve. Rabail will step off as the libero Bryn Lewis will come back in. And the GGs still maintain a comfortable 6-point advantage here in the third. Schaefer goes to Giddens, puts it over. Le Tourneau goes to the left for Roussel. Blocked by the GGs and down. Combination there from Janae McKay and Harper Schaefer with the stuff block. The Inuk managed to get a one hand on that first coverage, but went towards the back row. No one back there. A point to the GGs. Last minute substitution before Schaefer's serve as Jones comes in for Lewis. Overpass. This time, it's Odigi on the party ball. Been talking up the GGs all night, showing their discipline at the net, not swinging on those party balls, but going up with two hands. This time with the ball a little bit further off the net, it's smart for DG to swing on that, managed to get the snap, put it a little deeper, and she makes no mistake. Schaefer serve, good pass, Le Tourneau goes to the slide for Roussel, dug by Jones. Schaefer to Odigi, and that's how it's done. Kill by Odigi down the line, smart shot, gives the GGs an 18-9 lead. Bit of a giggle from Odigi after that one, showing the middle, Lorian Roussel. Yeah, that's how you get a kill. Schaefer serve, another good pass. Les Tourneaux goes to the left side. Elodie Roussel tipped over. Odigi picks it up. Schaefer, Gittins, dug by Gagnon. Great pickup. Now a left side ball to Roussel. Swing over, good dig by Gittins. Right side, pardon me, middle ball. What a set, Harper Schaefer. Have a day. From her knees, puts that right to Danae McKay. Served it up on a platter in the middle. Made no mistake, punishing that ball into position number six. What a play there by the Gigi's. Now Schaefer with another serve. And another good one. Long run, Les Tourneaux. Roussel rolls it over. Gets a kill. Tough angle from Elodie Roussel, but managed to find some court off the block touch and just out of the reach of Audrey Odigi. Substitution for the Inuk, number four, Karine Oud, coming in for number nine, Victoria Di Pietrantonio. And the serve will belong to number five, Beatrice Les Tourneaux. Good pass, Gittins. Schaefer, left side to Hildebrand. Blocked, picked up Odigi. Gittins sets. Hildebrand gives a free ball. Les Tourneaux to the middle. Roussel with the swing, blocked by McKay. Great rejection there by Janae McKay. Solo block on the middle swing, taking away all the options. And the Gigi's now doubling up the Inuk by a score of 20-10. This set was close at the start, but the Gigi's have really pulled away here in their last one or two service runs. Take a big 10-point lead. Les Tourneaux goes to the left side, and a kill from Karine Oud. Just out of the reach of the left side, Cameron Gittins. Elodie Roussel to serve for the Inuk. The left side, standing float, good serve. Lewis pops it up. Tight set to Hildebrand, manages to pop it over. Les Tourneaux goes to the right side for Oud, blocked by Gittins. Great play there by Cameron Gittins, solo block, but manages to take that cross-court shot away from Oud. Shuts it down, and the Gigi's up 21-11, just 4 points away from closing out this match in a sweep. Haven Fournier looking to check in here. Problem is for the Gigi's, we're not sure who she's trying to check in for. Looked like they tried checking her in for Janae McKay, but in the end it will be for Nicole Hildebrand. So Fournier will check in and play right side for the Gigi's. McKay's serve. Good float. Gagnon, Les Tourneaux. Bergeron rolls it over. Popped up. McKay sets out a system. Gittins gives a free ball over. Tight pass. Les Tourneaux one-handed set. And a kill from Lorian Roussel. Impressive set there from Beatrice Les Tourneaux. One-handed set going up. Putting it up for Roussel. Made no mistake. And put it off the arms of Rabar and down. Now a serve from Lorian Roussel. High pass from Gittins. Robert sets out a system. Odigi puts a free ball over. Oud, Les Tourneaux. And now another kill in the middle from the Inuk. This time it's Lena Kerenaut. And the Inuk have gotten 2 points in a row here. Gigi's lead by a score of 21-13. Lorian Roussel still on serve. Float from the middle. Good pass. Schaefer, quick shoot there to Rabar. Couldn't quite connect with her. Set was a little bit low. Always difficult with those sets off the net, trying to run a middle ball. I love the aggression from Schaefer there. Just unfortunately a little bit too low for Rabar to do anything with. And that'll be a point to the Inuk. Another float from Roussel. Good pass from Lewis. Schaefer goes to the left side for Gittins. Les Tourneaux. Bergeron rolls it over. Lewis to Schaefer. Odigi in the back row. Into the tape. Point to the Inuk. And that's four straight now for the Inuk as they pulled it within six. The Gigi's lead shrinking slowly but steadily. And as they lead 21-15, head coach Lionel Woods calls timeout. Gigi's leading 21-15 in the third set over the Université du Québec à Chicoutimi Inuk. And looking to put this match away, needing just four more points to secure a victory and move to 9-6 in the RSEC. Odigi pass. Schaefer with the set. Fournier rolls it over. Now Letourneau goes to the right side for Oud. Blocked, but stays on the side of the Inuk. Now a tip from the Inuk. Long run. Odigi can't get there in time. And Chikutsimi wins another point. That's now five straight from the Inuk. And the Gigi's will look to have to stop this run from Lauriane Roussel as soon as possible. Another float serve. Great pass from Lewis. Left side ball to Giddens. One-on-one swing, but a dig from the Inuk. Now a roll shot over, finds tape. Fournier takes it. Overpass, somehow dug by Odigi, and the Gigi's get the ball back over. Letourneau goes to the right side for Oud. Another dig from Odigi. Now Schaefer sets the left side and Giddens. Oud, Letourneau, run the middle to Kerenout. Great dig by Schaefer. Lewis sets out a system. Giddens with the swing. Good dig by the Inuk. Right side swing and a kill from the Inuk. It's Corinne Oud. Pulls the Inuk to within 4 points. What a rally. 21-7 now, the Gigi's advantage. Still up by four, needing four more to win. But starting to look a little more dicey than it was a few points ago. We'll have to fight for this one. Lewis, Schaefer, Giddens with the swing. There's a kill from the Gigi's to stop the run. And it's Cameron Giddens. Big swing off the not quite out of system set, but from behind the attack line. Managed to turn her body, get that outside cut, go off the hands, the middle, and out. Now it's Fournier to serve for the Gigi's. Good float from Fournier. Letourneau goes to Bergeron, and off the hands of Jones, and out. Tried to get out of the way of that one, did Jones. Just not quite able to pull that platform in at the last second, and it'll be a point to the Inuk. Now Corinne Oud on serve. Flat float serve. What a pass from Odigi. No, too tight. Schaefer unable to get there. 22-19. Excellent serve there from Corinne Oud. Super flat. Looked like Odigi made a good pass, but put it just a little bit too tight for Harper Schaefer. Had to try to play it off the net and couldn't quite get it up. Inuk within three. But that'll help the Gigi's cause. Missed serve by Corinne Oud. Point to the Gigi's, and they now lead 23-19. A win tonight for the Gigi's would put them in a tie for third place in the RSEC. Although with the teams ahead of them having some games in hand, it will make things a little bit trickier. However, the Gigi's playoff push still very much alive. Float from the Gigi's goes just long. That was Cameron Giddens putting it out the back, and that'll be 23-20 now the score. Coming back to the playoff standings, the Gigi's sitting at 8-6, as do the Laval Rouge et Or, but given that Laval has won the season series 2-1 against the Gigi's, they hold that tiebreaker. Sitting ahead of the Gigi's are the Sherbrooke Var et Or and the UQAM Citadin. As Odigi's swing goes just long, that'll be a point to the Gigi's. Pardon me, the point to the Inuk. They now trail 23-21. Although, head official calling over all of his officials, discussing a block touch. Gigi's sure think there was one. We'll see what the verdict is. But with the Var et Or sitting at 8-5, as do the Citadin. And the Gigi's and Rouge et Or both at 8-6. That third to sixth is tight in the RSEQ. And the Gigi's may just well be poised for a playoff appearance. Again, it's only the top four teams in the conference that qualify for playoffs. But with a win tonight, the Gigi's would be squarely in that mix. And there's match point coming up. The dump from Harper Schaefer gives the Gigi's a 24-21 lead. It'll be a timeout from the Inuk on match point. When we come back, Gigi's leading 24-21. Her float serve. Well past Gagnon. Les Tourneaux goes to the slide for Karen out. And a kill from the Inuk. They will live to see at least one more point. The score now 24-22. Gigi's next home game is on January 28th as they will host the Sherbrooke Vare Or. That will be a pivotal match in the Gigi's playoff push. The Gigi's beat the Vare Or at home a few weeks ago before Christmas. As there's an ace in the back row. And the Inuk, 24-23 now. Karen now with the ace to pull within one. But as mentioned, Gigi's next home game on January 28th with big playoff implications. Make sure to come out and support the girls as they look to qualify for playoffs. Serve from Karen out. Great hustle by Bryn Lewis to get that ball over. Fournier runs it over. Fournier pops it up. Schaefer sets Odigi on the left side. Tipped over. Les Tourneaux goes to the left for Roussel. Fournier with the dig. Schaefer. Tough play, Odigi. She can't get it over. And we're all tied up at 24. Gigi's led by as much as 20 to 10 earlier in this set, but the Inuk have come all the way back. Tied at 24-24. And the Gigi's following this time. The Gigi's and the Inuk locked in a tight battle here in this third set. 24-24 the score. Gigi's had a big lead earlier in this set, as much as 20-10, but the Inuk have stormed all the way back. Inuk had an out on serve. Good pass. Odigi on the left side. Dig comes back over. Giddens sets to Schaefer. Now Fournier forced to give a free ball over. Lauriane Roussel with the swing, but a block from Janae McKay. Clutch block from the middle will set up another match point for the Gigi's. Great discipline by the Gigi's all around there, not panicking, staying calm, getting that block. And now Harper Schaefer with a big serve for the Gigi's. Good float. Les Tourneaux to Roussel, picked up by Giddens. Schaefer gives it back to her on the pipe, swing in. Les Tourneaux sets the C ball, dug by Giddens. Les Tourneaux to the middle for McKay, and it's over! The Gigi's win a tight third set, maybe tighter than it needed to be, but they sweep the Chicoutimi Inuk, move to 9-6 on the season with a home sweep on a Friday night. Great match by the Gigi's all around. Domination in the first set, winning by a score of 25-10, then consistent 25-21 victory in the second and a scary 26-24 win in the third gives them the win. Thank you so much for tuning in on a Friday night. Gigi's next home game will be on January 28th, 2024 as they host the Sherbrooke Vare Or in a huge playoff matchup. Pardon me, hopeful playoff matchup. Gigi's have some work left to do, but with a win like that, it is promising. On behalf of myself and the entire crew here at Montpetit, thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll see you at the next one. Have a great night.